Part 4, the address. Now, when the narrator goes inside the house of Mrs. Darling, she finds that everything, not only the table cover, but the cutlery, the antique plates, and the Hanukkah, everything she finds her own, and she feels very uncomfortable over there. Then she tells the girl that how she didn't know that the cutlery set from which she's eating the forks and the knife she is eating from were of silver. And she asks that girl that if she knew. Naturally, the girl also did not know. She had her hand on the drawer. "Don't you want to wait for my mother?" So she says that when, but she finds that the narrator, she has got up and she was saying that she must catch her train. Then that girl asks that she didn't want to wait for her mother. "No, I must go. I walk to the door." The girl pulled the drawer open. "I can find my own way." And the narrator tells her, "No, she must go." She walked to the door. "As I walked down the passage, I heard the jiggling of spoons and forks." And as she was coming down the passage, she heard the light metallic sound, jingling sound of the spoons and forks that girl must be seeing in the drawer. "At the corner of the road, I looked up at the nameplate, and when she came at the corner of the road, she again looked up at the plate, 'Marconi Street,' it said. I had been at number 46, and she remembers that she had went to the number 46. The address was correct, but now I didn't want to remember it anymore. But now there's a difference in her attitude. She doesn't want to remember that address. I wouldn't go back there because the objects that are linked in your memory with the familiar life of former times instantly lose their value. When severed from them, you see them again in a strange surroundings." So she says, "I wouldn't go back there." She wouldn't go back to that address again because the objects, because the things which are linked in her memory with the familiar life of former times, because those objects, they linked her with the former times. And now they have lost their value when they are severed from, when they are separated from, cut from them. And now she sees them in a strange atmosphere. So she says, when you see your things, your objects, which were very precious to you in a strange atmosphere, you lose their value. "And what should I have done with them in a small rented room where the shreds of blackout paper still hung along the windows and no more than a handful of cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawer?" And then she makes up her mind. She says, what she will do with all these cutlery sets, which all these precious things, when she's living in a small rented room, where the tiny pieces, shreds, tiny pieces of blackout paper still hung on the windows. And no more than a handful of cutlery fitted. And she has got a small narrow drawer. Usme sirf handful cutlery aati hai. Aur war ke time ke jo tiny papers hain, wo abhi bhi uski window pe chipke hue hain. "I resolved to forget the address." So she made up her mind. She promised herself that she will forget that address. "Of all the things I had to forget." And then she thinks she has to forget all those things. That would be the easiest. That would be very, very easy for her. She finds that the things there had lost all their value for her. She has no more longing for them because they are in the strange atmosphere. She doesn't like them anymore. So in the end, we find that the narrator remembers the time when her mother was alive and the narrator was at home, and then how those things, they were connected to her. And she felt that now those objects that were linked to her memory is no longer exist, and they have lost their value in this strange atmosphere. Then she comforted herself by thinking that her present house was too small to accommodate all this stuff, and she left the house. So the message which we get from this chapter is that war, first of all, is the war, how this war occur, and how the people are lose their near and dear ones, they lose their belongings, kaise unki jo bhi precious cheeze hoti hai, unki jo memory hoti hai, they lose all that. And the war, they bring miseries, they bring separations and the loss. Then the second thing is that we also learned that how unethical is the behavior of Mrs. Darling. She took their things, took the things of the narrator and her mother, and now she doesn't recognize them. So unethical of her. She doesn't recognize also. And this is not the way, the respectful way or dignified way of a lady to treat the narrator when she comes back. So these are the message we learn from this chapter. We should be very, very respectful. We should have dignity of others. Respect the dignity of others. So I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you.